He went from being a Midwestern singer-songwriter to an established international star. But Dan Fogelberg ultimately settled in Colorado, a fitting destination for a quiet man of music, to quote one of his best-known lyrics.
A quiet man of music, denied a simpler fate.
Born in Illinois, Fogelberg was facilitated and supported in his musical growth by his father, Lawrence, a band leader and high school band director, and his mother, Margaret, a classically trained pianist. He grew up playing in garage bands and, while studying painting at the University of Illinois, realized music was the main focus of his creative talent. He left school to follow that muse and headed for the West Coast, finding inspiration during a week in Colorado before moving on. Under the aegis of his manager, Irving Azoff, Fogelberg secured a recording contract. His first album, Home Free, was recorded and produced in Nashville by Norbert Putnam. For his second release, Souvenirs, Fogelberg enlisted producer Joe Walsh, who had recently recorded at Caribou Ranch in Colorado. With Walsh's help, Fogelberg expanded on his sparse, countrified folk sound. His growth as a songwriter was most evident on Part of the Plan, a buoyant, radio-friendly hit single that catapulted him into the commercial firmament at the height of the California rock explosion. Alongside such hitmakers as the Eagles, Jackson Browne, and Joni Mitchell. While touring through Colorado in the mid-1970s promoting Captured Angel, his third album, Fogelberg learned that a mountain house was on the market. He fell in love with the Nederland spread and bought it from Chris Hillman, one of his favorite musicians who played with the Birds, the Flying Burrito Brothers, and Manassas. He flew to his Nashville farm to pack up his belongings and hurried back to his Rocky Mountain hideaway. He plunged into a season of solitude and composing, and it resulted in the songs for his next album, Netherlands. Writing in a more ornate and elaborately conceived idiom, it brought together his from-the-heart lyrics with lightly harmonized rock, pop, country, and folk ideas, with vestiges of the highly dramatic classical influences he'd absorbed from his parents.
Netherlands was written really about that whole experience of living up in the Nederland area. It was really not a coincidence, the title, you know, but it was a different concept, really. But it was about my first experiences about living in these mountains and how it affected me as an artist. And a lot of my work has been directly affected by my love for the Rocky Mountains and for Colorado.
Netherlands went platinum, and Fogelberg's signature sound endeared him to a loyal legion of fans. He'd write and record constantly, cutting tracks at Caribou Ranch and Boulder's North Star Studio. He recorded part of his next venture, Phoenix, in Colorado, and the songs Heart Hotels,
well, there's too many windows in this old hotel,
and Longer,
longer than there have been fishes in the ocean,
went to the top of the charts. The Innocent Age, released in 1981, included four of his biggest hits, Same Old Lang Syne, Hard to Say, Run for the Roses, an unofficial theme for the Kentucky Derby.
And it's run for the roses, as fast as you can.
And Leader of the Band, a tribute to his father.
The leader of the band is tired and his eyes are growing old. But his blood runs through my instrument, and his song is in my soul.
By 1980, Fogelberg had found and bought land outside of Pagosa Springs on the western slope of Colorado, where he constructed a house and barns. During the many hours spent driving his truck back and forth between Boulder and the ranch he was building, he listened to a lot of bluegrass tapes, feeding his desire to play some roots music again. After sitting in with Chris Hillman's acoustic band at the 1984 Telluride Bluegrass Festival, he made High Country Snows with some of his favorite bluegrass and country music pickers. In a world he defined as life in the fast lane, Fogelberg described the music as life in the off-ramp. The record became one of the best-selling bluegrass albums of all time. Every one of Fogelberg's first nine albums was certified gold or platinum. Reclusive by nature, Fogelberg led a quiet life in Colorado's San Juan Mountains. He let off steam playing anonymously in little Colorado bars in a good time rock and roll outfit called Frankie and the Aliens, formed with drummer Joe Vitale. Having shaved off his famous beard, he went virtually unrecognized and reconnected with the fun-loving approach to music. But shuttling between his satisfying seclusion in Colorado and the recording studios of Los Angeles, Fogelberg found his records took longer to make. So he built a home studio at his Mountain Bird Ranch.
There's a place in the Rockies, a place that I know.
The Wild Places, released in 1990, was the first album he self-produced and mostly tracked at his spread, which allowed him to be free from the time constraints of commercial studios. It included his soulful rendition of the Cascades' 1963 hit, Rhythm of the Rain.
Listen to the rhythm of the falling rain, telling me just what a fool I've been.
The cover peaked at number 3 on the Adult Contemporary chart. In 1993, on River of Souls, Fogelberg recorded in part at his Mountain Bird Studios and played most of the instruments himself. Fogelberg's long career was interrupted by a health crisis in mid-2004, when he was diagnosed with advanced prostate cancer. After battling for 3 years, he finally succumbed to the disease in December 2007.
Longer than there have been stars up in the heavens, I've been